Welcome. Have you ever wondered about the stories behind the names of every American country? Well, buckle up, because that's exactly what we're diving into today. From ancient tales to cultural roots, join me as we unravel the fascinating origins of each American nation's name. Let's dive in. Antigua and Barbuda. Antigua is Spanish for ancient, and Barbuda is also Spanish for bearded, although it is still known as Wadadli by the natives. The word Antigua was introduced by the explorer Christopher Columbus after a cathedral in Seville, Spain, named Santa Maria la Antigua. The word Barbuda could be related to the bearded inhabitants of the islands or the bearded fig tree present on the islands. Argentina. The country's name comes from the Latin word for silver, argentum, and Argentina is indeed a great source of valuable minerals. The word Argentina comes from Italian, first used in a Phoenician map in the year 1536, which meant made of silver, probably borrowed from the old French word Argentine, also meaning made of silver. The name Bahamas is derived from the Lucayan name Bahama, large upper middle island used by the indigenous Taino people for the island of Grand Bahama. Tourist guides often state that the name comes from the Spanish Baja Mar, shallow sea. The name Barbados is from either the Portuguese term Os Barbados or the Spanish equivalent, Los Barbados, both meaning the bearded ones, again referred to the bearded inhabitants or the bearded fig tree. Belize. The word is believed to be originated after the Belize River, originally called Baliz, from the Mayan word Balix, which means muddy watered. Other sources state that it might have originated from the Mayan phrase Belitza, meaning road to Itza, a local city of the Mayan Empire. Bolivia, named after Simon Bolivar, an independence fighter and leader who broke away from the Spanish rule in 1825. Brazil got its name from the Portuguese word for Brazil wood, a local tree called Pau Brasil, with Brazil meaning red like an ember, also from the word brasa, meaning ember. Canada likely comes from the Huron-Iroquois word kanata, meaning village or settlement. In 1535, two Aboriginal youths told French explorer Jacques Cartier about the route to Kanata. They were actually referring to the village of Stadacona, the site of the present-day city of Quebec. Chile. This one has two popular theories. One suggests that the Incas called the valley of the Aconcagua Chile after a tribar chief called Tili. The other theory says that it comes from the Mapuche word Chile, meaning where the land ends, or from the Quechua word Chiri, meaning cold. Colombia. This one is straightforward. It derived from the last name of the explorer, Christopher Columbus. Costa Rica. This means rich coast in Spanish. When Christopher Columbus came to Costa Rica in 1502, he believed that the land was filled with precious metals, like gold. Because of this belief, he called the land Rich Coast, or Costa Rica. The name Cuba comes from the Taino language. The exact meaning of the name is unclear, but it may be translated either as where fertile land is abundant, Cubao, or great place, Coabana. Dominica, named by Christopher Columbus after the Latin term Dominicus, meaning Sunday, the day when the explorer discovered the island, Dominican Republic. You might think it also comes from Dominicus, but surprisingly, it doesn't. It actually comes from the founder of the Order of the Dominicans, Santo Domingo de Guzman, referred to as Saint Dominic in English. Its capital, Santo Domingo, also comes from him, Ecuador. This is the only country in the world that got its name from the scientific and geographical term for the equator. Now, the word equator comes from the Latin equator, from the phrase circulus equator diei et noctis, meaning circle equalizing day and night. With that being said, the word equator means equalizing. El Salvador. The country was named after the Spanish word for the Savior in honor of Jesus Christ. The country of Granada has its origin uncertain, but likely to be named after the Spanish city of Granada. The word Guatemala comes from the native Nahuatl word Cuauhtemalan, meaning place of many trees, Guyana. Guyana is an Amerindian word that means land of many waters. And Guyana's name was chosen at independence to preserve that early imagery. Haiti. It comes from the indigenous Taino language and means land of high mountains. Honduras. It translates to depths in Spanish, referred to the depth of the Trujillo Bay in modern-day Honduras. The word Jamaica actually derives from the Arawak word Zaymaca, meaning land of wood and water. The name Mexico is a Nahuatl term derived from the words metztli, moon, zictli, navel or center, and co, place. Mexico's name, therefore, means the place in the center of the moon and refers to the fact that the Aztecs built Tenochtitlan in the middle of the Lake of the Moon, later called Lake Texcoco, Nicaragua. The country got its name from Nicarau, the chieftain of a powerful indigenous tribe, and the Spanish word for water, agua. For Panama's earliest inhabitants, fishing was central to life. It is therefore not surprising that the name Panama comes from an indigenous word that translates to abundance of fish. The name Paraguay stems from the Guarani word paragua, meaning feather crown, and wai, meaning water. Putting it together, we got feather crown of waters. The name Peru is derived from a Quechua word implying land of abundance, a reference to the economic wealth produced by the rich and highly organized Inca civilization that ruled the region for centuries. Saint Kitts and Nevis. In the 17th century, a common nickname for Christopher was Kit. Hence, the island came to be informally referred to as Saint Kitts Island, later further shortened to Saint Kitts. Columbus gave Nevis the name San Martin, Saint Martin. Saint Lucia was named after Saint Lucy of Syracuse. Saint Lucia is one of two sovereign states in the world named after a woman and is the only one named after a human woman. Ireland is named after a goddess. Saint Vincent and the Grenadines. Before 1498, the island was called Ulumain, in honor of Yuluka, a spirit that supposedly inhabited the island. Christopher Columbus named the island Saint Vincent, since it is said to have been discovered on 22nd of January, the feast day of the patron saint of Lisbon and Valencia, Vincent of Saragossa. Again, Grenadines might have derived from the Spanish city of Granada. Suriname, from the indigenous people called Surinen, or from the river Surinamo. Trinidad and Tobago. Christopher Columbus named the Trinidad portion after the Holy Trinity. Rumor has it people started calling the other smaller island Tobago because of all the tobacco grown by the natives there. United States of America. This one is very simple. It means the union of states, 50 to be exact, in America, the continent. The word America comes from the explorer Amerigo Vespucci. Uruguay. It is named after the Uruguay River. The word itself might have derived from the native Guarani, meaning bird river. It could also refer to a river snail called Uruguay. Venezuela. According to the most popular and accepted version, in 1499, an expedition led by Alonso de Ojeda visited the Venezuelan coast. The stilt houses in the area of Lake Maracaibo reminded the Italian navigator Amerigo Vespucci of the city of Venice, Italy. So he named the region Veneziola, or Little Venice. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Which country surprised you the most? Let me know in the comments below. Until next time, bye.